Okay, but we mentioned that we wanted to create, to display this joke in a Power App. So let's go into the Power App dashboard. And in order to connect the Power App to an Azure function, there's many choices, but we're gonna go through the simplest one, which is creating a custom connector. And here I'm gonna click create from blank. I'm gonna give it the name API jokes, and now you'll know how many dry runs I've done, more or less. So API jokes 8, click continue. Then we're gonna upload a picture. I wanna make sure that I include a picture that allows me to quickly identify my own custom connector. And then it's going to ask for my host, which is jokesapi.azurewebsite.net. And then our base URL is API. The next option that we have available here in our custom connector is the authentication type. And remember, we chose anonymous for our function. But of course, you can use different types of authentication. So if your function uses a security code, or maybe if you need to use OAuth 2.0, you can definitely use that in your custom connectors as well. Let's move on to the definition. We want to add a new action, and this is where we actually call the function method. So let's call this generate joke. And then the operation ID is the same. And our request will be a get method at this particular URL, which I've mentioned many times already. We're importing that to define the schema of our request. And then we want to define the schema for our response as well. So instead of defining it manually, I'm actually going to import it from sample. So what I'll do is copy this long joke that has been created here for us, and then import that, and I will generate a very simple pattern here. I'm going to create connector. And again, as I mentioned, this is one of the simplest ways of creating custom connectors. My colleague Justin will actually have a talk later on that will give you more advanced use cases, and I highly recommend you come back for that, for his talk. And there's a few other folks that are talking about serverless and custom connectors and more advanced use cases, so please stay tuned and check out those talks as well. Okay, now I'm gonna go into test, and this is where I'm going to have to create a connection to our function app, which is just as simple as clicking create, and our connection is now available. So yay, we are ready to create a new app. We're going to create a new Canvas app from blank. Let's call it Death AI, right? That's Donna and Seth, Death AI. Does that work? I hope so. Okay, so creating a new Power App, and this is going to be the simplest Power App that you will have ever seen. It's literally just a screen with a button and a text. When we click the button, we'll call the function app, and when the response comes back, we're going to show that response into the text right here. So let's go ahead and insert a button. And of course, you can create more complicated UIs with the Power App, as complicated as you want them to be. But in this case, let's keep it simple. Let's rename this as get joke, and then also add our label. We want to make this bigger in case our joke is a large one. So in this get joke on select, we want to use the clear collect method, which brings us the data from the API, and we want to save that data into a response collection, and then we want to call the function API. But hey, we haven't actually connected our Power App to our custom connector, so let's go into the Power Apps data option here, and in our connectors, you can see that we will find here API. One second. So we have API jokes 8. We want to add that connection. We want to click connect. And immediately our function will become available here. So if I click, if I write, start typing API jokes, it will already autocomplete to generate joke. And then bam, this is our API call. And then when we go back to our label, instead of displaying hard-coded text, we want to display our response. And actually we want to get the first element of our response. One second, just here. And then we want to retrieve the joke property or display the joke property. Okay, cool. So if everything's connected correctly, our application should run and it would retrieve the next joke. So the way I'm going to test this, you can either click preview the app here. So that's what I'm going to do. And then click get joke. And this is loading. It's loading. And now we're getting ready for the best AI generated joke ever. In a bit. Well, that is not working out correctly. So Death AI is punished right now. What do you call a pretty cow on a book? For the first name, I don't know my shoes. That is so, 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 so random. But hey, it works. The other thing that it will be your homework for next time that we meet is actually going into Power Automate and create a flow that will use the exact same API. And it will, instead of displaying it in a Power App, what we want to do is actually send that as a message using the Twilio API. So you can see here that I've already created this stateful orchestration that runs every minute or every week or every day, depending on how often you want this to be displayed. And then it makes an HTTP call, it parses that JSON, and it sends the text message to a phone number that you've just chosen. So this is your homework. You have to send me a message with AI generated jokes.